Hi everyone, this is Piero, I am the CEO of Mnemonica, and in this video I will show you how we addressed a very important issue like the user account security in the version 2 of our platform codename Mnemonica 2. In this release we introduced a lot of cool stuff in terms of security, such as the MFA, multi-factor authentication, passwordless login and more. Let's get started then. Every day we hear people complaining that the practices of securing their accounts are becoming an obstacle to their use. So, the goal we set for ourselves was to try to make cybersecurity a simple thing. No longer an annoying obstacle between the user and the content, but a tool to simplify digital lives and provide greater control. The following demo is done in an Apple ecosystem, but works in the same way on Google Chrome paired with Android devices. Okay, let's go and let's start from the beginning. Registering a brand new account. I go to my email client where I received an invitation from Mnemonica for the address info@mnemonica.com, which will be the username of the new account. I click on Join Mnemonica and I go to the registration page. Here I am. I type in my personal data and Safari asks me if I want to use a strong password. The best way to protect an account is to ignore its password. No one can spill us an information we don't have. Security by obscurity. So yes, I choose to use a strong password. I read and approve the terms, read and approve the privacy policy, and click on Create. Done. Now I close the confirmation page, and I go back to my email client. I have received right now an email with a link to confirm my email address, and this is super common procedure. I click on the link and I get redirected to the login page. Now, as you can see, Safari provides me already the credentials with my strong password saved into the internal keychain of my laptop connected to my personal Apple ID. This means that my brand new Mnemonica's credentials I just typed in are now shared on all the devices connected to my Apple ID, not even knowing the password. Now, I put my finger on the fingerprint reader of my laptop to do the first login, and as welcome message, Mnemonica reminds me to enable the multi-factor authentication on my account. For now, I click on later just for demo reasons, but my suggestion is to enable MFA at the very beginning and then forget it. The homepage is, of course, empty. I click on the blue bar to accept the new invitation I received and I click on accept. Okay, now I have a project on the board. And as you can see on its card, there's an MFA required tag. This means that I cannot access this project until I enable the MFA on my account. Whether a project requires MFA is decided by the owner, following their needs, as there may be less important projects where restrictions may be lighter. If I click on the card, I receive an access denied notification. Also, an MFA icon is pulsing here above my avatar, reminding me to enable it, and so I do. Okay, I click on the icon and I get redirected to the account settings security page to set up MFA. I click on enable MFA button here and I add a method. I can have four types of methods plus one that I will show you later. An authenticator app, one or more, a PIN code, the SMS method, and a secondary mail address, one or more also in this case. For all these methods, except for the PIN, you will be asked to type in a one-time password, OTP, received on the related channel. As these four methods work very well together to prevent the scenario where you get locked out of your account, I suggest enabling at least two of them, but if you want to enable just one, it's quite enough, and for this demo, I'll go with one. I picked the authenticator one, which, to my personal point of view, is the most secure and reliable. I give it a name because I can have more than one on my iPhone, on my iPad, on my Android, and so on, as many as you want. The more methods you enable, the easier it is to recover your account if something goes wrong with your credential or your devices. I type Piero's iPhone. Okay, now I unlock my phone here, open an authenticator app. In this case, I have chosen Microsoft Authenticator, but you can use any authenticator app on the market. It's the same. As you probably noticed, this app is itself protected by my biometrics. So I'm the only one who can access the OTPs the authenticator provides. And this is good for security. I tap on the plus button to add a new service. The camera of my iPhone turns on, asking me to frame the QR code that I have on my browser page. I frame it and I get it. I click on next. I wait a second for the renewal. Okay, 7, 8, 9, 6, 5, 4. Next. Okay, done. Now I have the MFA active on my account. Now I close the setting page and I go back to my dashboard. Above my avatar, the MFA pulsing icon is disappeared. And if I click on the project card, now the access is granted. Okay, let's log out for a while. I open the Mnemonica app on my iPhone and I type in the new username. As said, I don't know the password. I click on my keychain button to recover it directly from my iCloud keychain, which is instantly accessible thanks to my biometric data. I select info@mnemonica.com from the list and I turn on biometric security on the login. This flag authorizes my biometric data to renew MFA requirements seamlessly in the encrypted keychain of my device. This, with the same level of security, prevents the user to be asked for MFA on every login. Logging once and then Mnemonica takes care of your identity thanks to the device biometric capabilities and the keychain. Now this device becomes a trusted one, and I will go back on this concept later. But I tell you, if you don't access Mnemonica on your app for more than 30 days, you will be kicked out and you will need to input your credentials and MFA to log in again. I suggest to use biometric security for the best user experience and security level. I tap on login and now the app asks for an OTP from the authenticator app. So I go back to it. I wait for a second to the code to renew. Okay. I copy the OTP and paste it here and tap login. Okay. Now I am in. Now let's go back on the browser and assume the case that you need to connect to Mnemonica from a post-production facility or a production office computer or even from an internet cafe on a computer and a network which are not under your control, that you don't know. Those devices, of course, are not connected to your main ID, Apple's or Google's, and you can't automatically access the credentials on your personal keychain. The solution in this case is to go manual. Read the credentials from your keychain and type them into the browser session. Okay, this is super unsafe, because those devices and those networks could be infected with sniffers, malwares, and other malicious pieces of software that can steal your credentials and your identity. So how can I connect to my Mnemonica account safely on those devices? Easy. You can use our passwordless login. Now, I go back to my mobile application, I tap on my avatar on the top right of the screen and select passwordless login. I authorize the camera, and now I frame the QR code on the login page on the browser. Boom, I am in. And this browser session is protected as your mobile session, thanks to MFA and biometric security, and you have only scanned a QR code. This is super secure and super fast. Are you still convinced that security is an obstacle rather than an opportunity? Think about it. Now, if I go back on the account settings security page, my iPhone appears under the list of the trusted devices, showing the creation date and the last access date. Remember, a trusted device will store securely the MFA information at the first login and will never ask the user for it again. To be clear, only the Mnemonica app and Mnemonica Gate can be trusted devices, not a browser session. Now, let's go back for a while to the previous use case. You have logged in on a production office computer. You left the office forgetting your session open. Oops. Anyone now can access your account. But don't worry, we have something for you. Mnemonica lets you log out from other open sessions remotely. If you click on this button, you can close all the open sessions except the one you are using to prevent other people to use your account. I'm going to show this on the mobile application. So I go back to my app and open the security page. Here, by the way, you can set your MFA methods, check the list of the trusted device, and if you want to log out from other sessions, you can. Let's do it. I tap on the logout from other sessions button, and yes, log out now, done. Now, back on my browser, if I close the page, look, the token is expired, and I've been kicked out from Mnemonica. What a relief, isn't it? One more thing to emphasize the importance of our mobile app in the Mnemonica user experience, because itself becomes the key to Mnemonica. As said, only Mnemonica app and Mnemonica gate can be trusted devices. So every time you need to log in on a browser, you need to input your credentials and the second factor of authentication. When you enable MFA on your account and you log in with your mobile app with biometric security, your app itself becomes a method. How this works? Look, I type in my credentials on the browser. In this case, I use my fingerprint, but this is unrelated. It's just a shortcut. The MFA window pops up, and as you can see, the mobile application is presented as the default MFA method. Seamlessly, I receive a notification on my phone, a push one when the app is in the background, or if you have the app open, like in this case, a pop-up asking me, "Is that you?" Yes, it's me. I'm the one who is trying to log in. You don't need to type OTPs, which are annoying. You don't need to use your authenticator, the SMS, the PIN, or the OTP received on a secondary mail address anymore. Just tap the notification and you are logged in. Pretty smooth. So, bottom line, when you're working with Mnemonica and you want to have a safe and straightforward experience, enable MFA on your account, install your Mnemonica app, and use it not only to work with content, but as your key to the Mnemonica ecosystem. As you have seen from this demo, In our vision, security leads users to have more control, more power, and a more effortless user experience. Okay, guys, thanks for watching this. Please visit our support portal at support.mnemonica.io. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more on Mnemonica. Stay safe and see you soon.